All right, we're back on the Hampton Road Show with Virginia Witt from Jackson Hewitt Tax Services. Now, we've got a little more than a week before the filing deadline for your state taxes. So what can you do if you need a little bit more time? Virginia Witt has some advice for us. If somebody right now is saying, I might need more time, do they pretty much need to be filing an extension?
Well, if they can get their stuff together before the 17th. The 17th this year, not the 15th.
Okay.
And the state is May 1st.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. So I mixed those up. The federal deadline is the 17th, May 1st for your state refund.
Right, right.
So if somebody hasn't started yet, is it conceivable that they could still get it done?
It's conceivable. It'd be rough, but they can do it.
Okay.
And if they can't, they can get a 4868, which is an extension.
Mm-hmm.
That's for federal.
Yeah.
It's an extension for a time to file, not for a time to pay.
So people still have to estimate how much they might owe and send a check, right?
That's right. We have to be mind readers, too.
Okay, so filing for an extension does not mean you're buying yourself some more time from having to spend the money.
That's right. You're still going to get a penalty if you don't pay enough taxes in by April 17th.
So then if you've got to estimate what you would owe, and you're going to look at certain pieces of paperwork to estimate, I mean, shouldn't you just go ahead and do your taxes?
Well, sometimes you don't have all the paperwork.
Okay.
So you have to do the extension. Kind of figure a dollar more than your tax liability the year before.
Okay.
That kind of helps you figure out what you need to send in.
Unless something has drastically changed in your life year to year.
Unless something has changed, yes. Well, the dollar more than the tax liability last year will keep you out of the penalty.
Okay.
So you can do that. Just send that in. And once you send an extension to the federal, Virginia gives you an automatic extension then, too, 6 months.
Okay.
So April 17th this year to October 15th is the extension dates.
So if you send a check to the federal government when you file for an extension there, you automatically get the extension from the state. Do you have to send a separate check estimating what you would owe the state?
If you owe the state, then you have to send the extension for the state, too.
Okay.
And that is with your check.
Okay.
Okay.
Is this a common thing? Do a lot of people do this? And do a lot of people do this without understanding how it's done and what it means?
A lot of people do it. If they do it, they understand what it means. And April and October 15th is a busy time again.
Okay.
Yeah.
So does Jackson Hewitt help people prepare an extension form as well as their taxes?
We sure do. We sure do. And we can do it electronically. They don't have to send anything in unless it's the money.
Right.
But you can also do that on a credit card, too.
Okay.
But the credit card company does charge for that, but you can do it that way. But if you're going to do it with a credit card, do it before April 17th, because it has to go all through the companies.
Mm-hmm.
And so it wouldn't get to the IRS in time if you did it on the 17th.
Does filing for an extension for your taxes affect your credit score? Is it something that would reflect poorly on you later on,
No.
or is it not a big deal?
No, not a big deal.
Is it better to do that than, you know, to just ignore these deadlines, I would imagine?
Definitely, because if you owe, you could get a late filing penalty.
Mm-hmm.
If you're getting a refund, you're not going to get the late filing penalty, but so you want to keep out of all these penalties.
Okay.
That could add up quite a bit if you owe quite a bit of money.
What if there was a part of your taxes that you forgot to file, didn't realize you had to file? Can you file for an extension on just a part if you realize you made a mistake, didn't include something you were supposed to include?
No, you've already filed your tax return.
So you're looking at an amendment?
You're looking at an amendment, but if you owe, you need to get this done quick so that the interest doesn't add up.
Okay. All right. So if you have not prepared your taxes yet, you can either go for it, or if it's looking like it's going to take longer than the days remaining before the deadline, look into filing an extension. If you have questions about that, you can reach Jackson Hewitt Tax Service online at jacksonhewitt.com, or you can call them with questions about extensions or any tax questions at 1-800-234-1040. And I know that you and all of your colleagues are looking forward to that deadline, too.
We
take a little bit of a breather.
Take a little bit of breather.
Before you help everybody who filed an extension.
Yes.